This year, as the BBC Proms celebrate their centenary season, BBC Radio 3 brings all 70 concerts live into your living room. So for the best seat in the house, tune to BBC Radio 3 and BBC 2 next Friday at 8 for a simultaneous broadcast of Mahler's 8th Symphony.
In 5 minutes tonight, the fluent, emotional guitar solos and voice of one of the greats of the rock world as BBC Two pays tribute to Rory Gallagher. The weekend weather view now on BBC Two from Rob McElwee.
Well, Friday brought us yet more thunderstorms of quite a tremendous nature. Almost we had a tornado seen to the south of Glasgow. Certainly Glasgow had a tremendous downpour, nearly an inch in about an hour. Those thunderstorms moved north into the mountains. We were not alone. Elsewhere in Europe, Berlin, for example, had 60 millimetres in the last 24 hours, well into the July average. This is a monthly average. Down in Toulouse, another fair amount. This was overnight. So the thunderstorms are not just generated by day because of temperatures. They are generated really because the atmosphere is quite unstable. You can see that the temperatures help a great deal. There's a huge swathe of central Europe which turns thundery every day, and Friday was no exception. Saturday we'll see a similar area, rather thundery, down towards northern Italy, back towards the Pyrenees. If you want summer sunshine, it's still there in the Mediterranean, really from west to east. But if you move inland, you're always at threat of humid weather and a thundery downpour. There's little real difference on Sunday. The temperatures down in the south and the sunshine are pretty high. In the States, they have been having very high temperatures, this time add 10 degrees, and this is a heat wave. The Plains heat wave that's now lasted 6 days and has hit records. In La Crosse, for example, we have not had this temperature recorded since 1936. Really, Chicago has been the highest it's ever recorded. Now, I'm not sure where the record started, but it's 11 degrees above the average, and they've never had 41 at any time of the year before. Not surprisingly, there have actually been fatalities. Well, the heat will last a little bit longer, but thankfully it is slowly declining and it will drop down towards Texas, New Mexico, where you'd expect it to be hot anyway. Back to us now, a bit of forecasting. We'll first of all run through the satellite pictures for the day, because you'll notice the movement. We've got everything moving north, round a centre, somewhere out here. This is where the depression is, that huge governing depression. Many of these showers were thundery. They're coming up in lines up through the Severn Estuary, for example, because the winds are southwesterly. They're coming up in arms. The arms that follow little troughs in the atmosphere, and of course many did turn thundery. To look forward from this evening until the next day, you'll find that showers along the south coast might move up and towards East Anglia, because there's a little trough running, little wavy system running through into northern France. Otherwise the showers are still directed largely by the wind, though they will be enhanced, I think, in West Wales. So on Saturday then we start off with one or two showers still in the east. Otherwise they've been running inland on the southwesterly, but fairly heavy showers, I think, from the word go, from the western Midlands up through Wales, northwestern England, in towards southwestern Scotland. Northern Ireland might escape the dry start. Eastern Scotland, the far northeastern England, likely to do just the same. But by the middle of the day, most of England and Wales and much of Scotland will be under fairly heavy showers. It'll turn brighter from the west, and that brightness will tend to spread across much of central England and Wales, leaving the heavier showers further north, Northern Ireland, central and southern Scotland. We've still got the breeze with us. It won't be as breezy on Saturday as it has been on Friday. It will be approximately as warm, which is typically 22 to 23 Celsius, low 70s Fahrenheit. Good evening.
Imagine yourself in a country which was designed by others and incorporated hundreds of cultures.
The 80 years of colonial experience have changed the two sides of the tribe.
But the country is changing. What do you do?
No problem. I would overrun the place within hours.
These people know the reality of the situation is Africa.
Dumela, Molo, Halal.
Through the lens of Africa's own broadcasting and a unique analysis of the roots of Africa's divisions, BBC Two explores the real Africa. TV Africa at 10 follows the map of Africa at 10 to 9, Sunday on BBC Two.
In tonight's Oscar-winning film in 50 minutes, How to Make a Meal Out of Dining with Friends. The guests arrive a day early and the army turns up on manoeuvres in the discreet charm of the bourgeoisie. A rock musician with a distinctive style, remembered now on BBC Two, some frank recollections make up our tribute to Rory Gallagher, who died last month.
Africa! Last grim outpost of barbaric yesterdays. So thought the Western world when it arrived to conquer.
When the white men came to Africa, the plains were teeming with animals.
They left behind near extinction and dispossession.
We were confined to certain places.
As part of African Summer, BBC Two examines the full crisis of Africa's big game. Part one begins Wednesday at 9:30.
Late Night Horror on BBC One in just over 5 minutes. David Selby stars in The Night of Dark Shadows. A large helping of wit now here on BBC Two at The Dinner Party from Hell, an Oscar-winning film from the BBC 100 collection, The Discreet Charm of the Bourgeoisie.